Hello again, everybody, and welcome to our weekly interview here on WWE.com. It is my pleasure to welcome our very special guest this week, none other than the 15-time world champion, John Cena. Welcome, John.
Thanks, Paul.
A week from Sunday, WrestleMania.
We're close.
You versus Rusev for the United States Championship.
Yeah.
This has been a long few weeks for you leading up to this point to finally have this match. Was this all just about you having yet another opportunity to compete at WrestleMania?
Not at all. If anything, I've learned a very valuable lesson, and hopefully one that'll make me more effective in every opportunity I get in the future. Stephanie McMahon put it very bluntly, and it was a giant piece of humble pie, but the WWE is going to be just fine without John Cena. But where would John Cena be without the WWE? And I can't give a good answer to that question. The WWE has provided me with a format to be who I am, to be aspirational, to inspire, to send my message, to perform, to be blessed enough to go out every day and do what I do. This is not about an opportunity to perform at WrestleMania. I openly said on Raw 2 weeks ago that if the lesson to be learned is it's not my time, because that spot at WrestleMania is a privilege. And if I haven't earned the privilege, then so be it. I do have an opportunity to compete at WrestleMania. And quite frankly, I believe that this opportunity is the most important of my WWE career.
Why?
Because normally at WrestleMania, you get the opportunity to showcase your ability. And it is a scenario where you can have self-achievement. You win at WrestleMania, it is great for you. I see what a lot of the WWE universe sees, especially those domestic here in the United States. I'm not taking anything away from Rusev. He's undefeated, he's damn near unstoppable. He's a 300-pounder that moves like a 180-pounder and has the strength of a 400-pounder. But he's had the opportunity to come to this country and have success in this country. And every single time he gets a chance to speak, all he does is belittle the United States of America, a country that I'm very proud to call home. Yet by wearing that United States championship, he is the representative of the United States of America. And I've had enough of it. And I don't think I'm alone. I've had my ups and downs with the WWE universe in the past, but I have listened. And every single one of those people is fed up with Rusev being the representative of the United States of America and with every bating breath running this country into the ground. And I don't think that's fair, and I'm sick and tired of it.
John, no disrespect, but do you know how many people before you over the last year have said the same thing that you're saying today? That they're sick and tired of Rusev running this country down, that they're going to stop him, they're going to beat his undefeated streak. Yet no one has been able to, yourself included.
Including myself. It's all I can do is hope for opportunity. And this is why I say that this is the most important opportunity of my career. Because I'm not fighting for just me. I'm fighting for all those before me who said this guy has to be stopped. I'm fighting for all those watching saying this guy has to be stopped. I'm not saying Rusev doesn't have any right to say what he's saying. The fact that he represents this country to me is appalling and disgusting, and it needs to stop. And I know what's at stake on March 29th. I know what's at stake at WrestleMania. And you're right. The batting average is zero. I am going to try to have to do what hasn't been done, including from myself. But here's where I put my advantage. I've been in the ring with Rusev. And I know it's going to be a battle. I've been through my share of battles. And I have been locked into that submission. And I stood to my feet, and I promise you, when I got to my feet, I knew I had him. And I didn't account for every variable. And that was my own mistake. People make mistakes. I'm not going to make that mistake again. I will be very well prepared come WrestleMania.
Who's to say that Rusev is going to make that same mistake?
Well, we're going to find out. And that's why they play the game, as you say. And that's what makes March 29th so important.
John, you'd mentioned before that the WWE is going to go on without John Cena.
100%.
So, with that being said, Has it crossed your mind at all that a week from Sunday could be it for you on the grand stage? That if you don't accomplish what you're hoping to accomplish against Rusev, or, you know, something worse, that this could be it for you there? Do those thoughts cross your mind?
Yes. At one point, or there comes a point where people lose faith. And every time in my career when I've been down and it looks like I'm out, I tell everybody, hang in there, hold on, I'm gonna dust myself off and I'm gonna come back fighting harder than I've ever fought. I had a couple extremely rough outings with the Beast Incarnate. I didn't get the job done at the Royal Rumble. It's been a rough 14 for me. And I didn't get the job done at Fastlane. There's only so many times that I can look those believers in the eye and say, listen, I got this one, before they realize that maybe I'm talking a game and not putting up. At WrestleMania, if I don't get the job done, I have to face those consequences. And I've made a pact with myself. I've been very vocal about this pact. When I can't keep up with the WWE superstars in the ring, I'd much rather gracefully bow out into the night than hang around much too long and have all the work that I've ever done to build this brand, this company, just go down the tubes for absolutely nothing. So yes, you're absolutely right. And that is a very real scenario, but I know what I got in here and I know I'm not there yet.
Final question, John. A week from Sunday, WrestleMania, for those of watching on pay-per-view or live in the WWE Network, what John Cena will they see?
You know, that's a great question. As I sit across from you in what I like to call the Superman outfit, this is the outfit I wear to go into battle, I've heard so many of my critics say, and this may be a little over the line, but I don't care. I don't like the character, but I respect the hell out of the man. Well, at WrestleMania, they're going to see a man, and they're going to see that man fight for what he believes in. And the reason they respect the man is because I wear my heart on my sleeve. I say what I believe in, and I say what I'm sick of. And I believe in this country, and I love this country. And there is documented proof of my unwavering support for the men and women who fight for our freedoms. I'm going into WrestleMania to stop all this. And I'm going into WrestleMania to take back that United States Championship so the US of A can have a rep with that championship that they can be proud of. And I've openly said that I want to go to these towns, every single town we tour in the United States of America, so people can come and see the champion that they can be proud of. And even when we go overseas, there's a reason Rusev thinks the way he does, because there could be, in some of these places, a misunderstanding about what the United States of America is about. I want to be that champion. I want to be that ambassador to go to places like the UK, to go to places like Japan, even Russia, to prove to them that America is the elite, because we bust our ass to be the elite. Not that anybody doesn't work as hard, but we will not waver. And I want to be that ambassador, to send a good message on behalf of the United States of America. And to me, WrestleMania is not about me. WrestleMania is about shutting up Rusev and bringing that championship back to where it belongs.